What is happening, Stealth Army, and welcome back to another Minecraft video today. I hope you guys are doing great, having a spectacular day. Today we are here with another Deep Dark and Warden video. This is directed towards my Tomb Raiders, not those people that are going to fight the Warden regardless of what happens. Some of you guys are about that action. For me, it's all about the treasure. It's all about the loot. And I have a feeling a lot of people that are watching this video feel the same way. So if you don't want to get murdered by the Warden, this is the video for you. So hopefully you guys do enjoy this video. I really appreciate all the support lately. Feel free to share your ideas down below. What type of items would you guys like to see out of the Deep Dark? And what type of update would you guys like to see announced during Minecraft Live? And I will be streaming the entire event from start to finish. So this is the spot for everything related to Minecraft Live. Join the Stealth Army, click that subscribe button. We all know that YouTube is constantly messing up as well. So hit that notification bell sign if you don't want to miss any content, any news related to the Deep Dark, the Warden, as well as Minecraft Live. Without further ado, guys, you know the routine, you know the drill. Let's get straight into it. So right now, the Deep Dark and the Warden are currently not available. I mean, they're not released. So unless you're playing like a modded world, you're just not gonna be able to access the Warden or the Deep Dark. However, there are plenty of caves right now in the snapshot, as well as the bedrock betas, that you can play around with. So that's exactly what we're gonna do. So what we're gonna do is go into game mode, and then we are gonna go into spectator. The first thing we're gonna do is find ourselves a nice big cave. Now, I imagine the Deep Dark is gonna come in all shapes and sizes. So, you know, just depending on the cave size, the strategy for approaching the Deep Dark and the Warden will clearly change depending on the cave and how it's formed and obviously how deep it is. So my first tip or suggestion is a pretty obvious one, but I have a feeling a lot of people are gonna forget some basic things. Have night vision before entering the Deep Dark. It's called the Deep Dark, right? So it's gonna be a very dark environment and you're simply just gonna get lost. Even just placing torches can only help you so much, especially if you're being chased by the Warden, then you're definitely not gonna have much time to do anything. So having night vision will help you in this type of situation, or even if you're not in a situation where you're getting chased by the Warden, being able to map the area out, scope the environment, figure out where you need to go next without necessarily placing torches or having an immediate light source will help you so much more than someone who doesn't have night vision. So make sure you have plenty of night visions before you enter the Deep Dark. And who knows how long it'll actually take you to find this biome. You might have to go through the Lush Cave in order to get to the Deep Dark or the Dripstone Cave or various other caves and tunnels well before you actually find the Deep Dark. My next tip would be not to enter the Deep Dark. I know that sounds crazy, and I know some of you guys could be like, what are you talking about, Stealth? But hear me out. If you stumble upon the Deep Dark, my advice would be to leave that biome and try and figure out a way to maneuver around the Deep Dark and figure out where everything is before actually going into that biome. It's that dangerous. And more than likely, if the Warden hears you, RIP, it's too late because the Warden is very fast. We've all seen the gameplay footage. The Warden can move really fast in that type of environment. So even just having a better idea where the mob is, where the Warden is, will help you so much. So my suggestion, build above the Deep Dark and build a tunnel system around the Deep Dark. That way, you can exit whenever you want, or if you're just trying to find the treasure room, I would try and tunnel my way to the treasure room and just be ready to build either straight up or straight down. Because more than likely, once you enter the Deep Dark, something is gonna give away your presence. If it's the sculk sensors, if it's your landing, some sort of noise might trigger a reaction that warns the Warden that you're there. So just be ready to dig straight down or build straight up. I'm not sure if scaffolding is the best block in the situation considering how loud it is. Like, scaffolding is pretty noisy, you gotta admit. So maybe having sand is a good idea, having dirt is probably a good idea, but I'm not sure about scaffolding. That might be a little bit too loud for the Deep Dark, so I would not bring scaffolding. It just seems like a really bad block to have in this type of environment. Also, having a bucket of water would be another good tip. I know this is another obvious one, but let's let's be real, a lot of people might forget these things before they actually enter the deep dark or go on a long adventure in hopes of finding one. So having a bucket of water is going to be extremely helpful. I don't think it's going to stop the warden, but it might possibly slow down the warden if you happen to disturb its peace or awaken it somehow. Like, accidents do happen. So having a bucket of water where you can just place it at any given moment is going to be very helpful. Even if you're just trying to distract the warden, I imagine that's going to be a good tool to have in the deep dark. I would also have obsidian, a lot of obsidian. I don't think that's going to stop the warden, but like I mentioned earlier, having something you feel like will slow down the warden might be the difference between life or death, right? Having that extra second or two to slow down a monster like the warden could honestly be the difference between the you died menu and having all the treasure and back on the surface where it's safe. So just have a lot of obsidian and ready to spam it if you're in that situation. But no matter what, you should be as quiet as possible in the deep dark. Even if you feel like you're prepared, you should be as quiet as possible because this is a really dangerous environment and I want everybody to succeed. That's why I'm making this video. I want to see the stealth army get the treasure, get the items, and escape safely. Now, a couple things I want to mention, which is the lava bucket. I'm not sure if that's going to do too much. If anything, it's probably going to make your time there more difficult, considering currently we cannot defeat the warden. That was announced and confirmed by the homie King B Dogs. You cannot currently defeat the warden, so having lava everywhere is probably not going to make your time there easier. It might just hinder you from actually escaping the deep dark. So I would encourage you guys to have water over lava for those of you who are like stealth. Why not just spam lava all over the place? That's probably going to make your time there a lot more difficult. But you can also use it as a light source if that's something you're trying to do. Another thing is trying to slow it down with TNT might actually work, but that's another thing that can backfire as well. So if your plan is to spam TNT all over the deep dark, like, I don't think that's a bad idea necessarily. All I'm saying is that can also backfire, either possibly destroying the treasure room or maybe killing yourself as well. Like, accidents do happen. So I would actually control the TNT as much as possible through either pressure plates by setting traps all over the place or redstone traps. Like, there's a lot of ways you can use TNT to hopefully slow down the warden, not kill the warden, because like I said, currently that's not gonna happen with anything that's in Minecraft. It's just not gonna end well for you. And I don't really encourage people to use TNT, especially if your goal is to collect everything in the deep dark, or just to keep that environment intact, like you don't want to destroy any of the blocks, then probably going the TNT route is not a good idea. There's a lot of other methods for just getting what you want without destroying the environment, especially if you just want to live in the deep dark. That's something I've even considered, like, do I want to make the deep dark my base? So if that's your objective, then you definitely don't want to destroy the deep dark, and you probably don't want to harm the warden because then you'll die. So there's a lot of ways you can trap the warden. But that all goes back to my initial tip, which is scoping out the deep dark, figuring out the layout of the deep dark well before entering it, because if you do, that's half the battle, and that allows you to place traps, that allows you to figure out ways where you can get the warden possibly stuck or slow it down for a little while, and you can plan ahead, right? That's the important thing. Plan ahead, because once you're in that environment, there's not much time. I think we can all agree with that. So I can make a part two if you guys want to hear more ideas, or even possibly just bringing the warden back to your base. We can figure out cool ideas for making that happen as well. So I want to say thank you guys again for all of the support lately. It really does mean a lot to me. So click that notification bell sign, and I'll see you guys in the next video. So take care. Peace.